LinkedIn can be a great source of lead generation for your business if you use it right. You can prospect hundreds of people each day and bring them into your marketing funnel. The process, if you want to do it right and build long-term relationships, is slow and very thorough. A lot of people make this mistake of sending a sales pitch to their new connections even before warming them up. Hey guys, this is Vishal Mehra. I'm a lead generation consultant. I help companies grow and scale up, leveraging the power of modern day marketing and automation. And in this video, which is the part two of a two-part series, I'm going to talk about how to leverage LinkedIn for lead generation. How to best use LinkedIn involves two parts to the process, with part one being a manual process, and in part two, we leverage some degree of automation. So till such time that we have warmed up our leads, we use the manual process. So before we begin, think of LinkedIn as a superpower when it comes to lead generation. If you've seen the other video, I have told you how to set your profile right. If not, you can go ahead and take a look at it. Now before we begin, let me say it and get it out of the way. Be respectful of the prospects you are connecting with. And before you even begin this process, do a lot of research. Understand the pain areas your connections may have by engaging them in a conversation first. If you can't engage them directly, see what groups are they a part of. Follow their comments, see what they are doing. It may take a little bit of time. It may even take a few days to get you to understand that. But once you do, the process will be a lot easier. So once you have sent in a connection request and you've personalized it, as I explained in the earlier video, the second email should not be a sales pitch straight away. So it takes a little bit of time. You know what are the pain areas if you've done your research. You know what are the kind of problems these people are trying to solve. Have some sort of white paper or a lead magnet you can share with them to engage them with your brand. Let me reiterate here, it takes between 15 to 20 touch points to create a brand recall. Engage them with your brand. Once you have started a communication, it would be a great idea to somewhere along the line get their email address. Now, mostly you'll be able to see the email address in the contact info, but it is also a good idea to ask them if you could share this white paper or lead magnet with them on the email. If you have nothing to offer, you are not providing any value to them. In which case, what is the reason that they would have to shift their business to you? So every single time that we use LinkedIn for lead generation, we carry out a thorough research. We first create a buyer persona. We try and see how can we provide this help to the buyer or to the prospect. What kind of help can we offer them? How can we engage with them? And we create a white paper or we create a lead magnet for that. So let's say you've been able to engage them. You've engaged them on the manual part. You've gotten their email address and they've agreed to receive a white paper from you. What would be your next step? At this point of time, we will shift from a manual process to an automated process. Just because you've connected with them on LinkedIn and shared a white paper or a lead magnet does not mean that you've been able to establish a brand recall in their mind. To do so, you need to leverage the power of automation and marketing. And at this stage, we use a three-pronged approach. You already connected with them on LinkedIn. That's the first point of contact. Then by sharing the lead magnet on the email, we have established a second point of contact. After this, what we need to do is we need to use automation to start showing them our brand on the social media. Even if they don't click on the link, all this helps create a brand recall. To set this efficiently, we need four tools. Tool number one, to sync your contact details from LinkedIn to your CRM, you need either a tool called Link Match or Linked Hub. And in the later part of this video, I will show you how to use these tools. If you have the budget, I would suggest go with Linked Hub, as it can help you move your entire conversation from LinkedIn to your CRM. Tool number two, of course, is the CRM. Now, if you have a CRM already in your company, great, use that. If not, may I recommend that you use HubSpot? It's a free tool, it works well, it has lots of integrations, and I have a complete video on this. If you happen to be from the travel domain, I have a 7-part series on how to use LinkedIn and how to set it up. If you're a small business or a solopreneur, I do have a video, or you could watch the travel series and the travel series for CRM and set it up based on similar lines for your business. Now, tool number three after the CRM is the email marketing automation tool. Now, I prefer to use something like Sendinblue or ActiveCampaign for this one. See, the reason is we need to sync our audiences from the CRM with Facebook, and this will help us create targeting and retargeting ads. Now, these ads are just to create touch points, nothing else. In your email marketing tool, you would need to create an automation journey map, which would drive the whole process. From when to share, what audience to move them to, how to move them around, that'll all become a part of this automation journey map. And finally, we have tool number four, which is an automation tool called Zapier or Automate. I do have a video on this as well, in case if it interests you, to understand how you can connect your various apps together. So what this will do is, it would help the data flow seamlessly between your CRM to your Facebook audiences, and this makes your life a lot easier. It'll not only save you time, but it'll also make sure that no contact is missed. Once we have these four tools, we can jump onto the computer and I can show you how to create this entire process. So getting to the process of how you're going to connect the four tools. The first tool that you need is called LinkedHub. And LinkedHub is a great tool because it syncs the data totally from your LinkedIn account and everything to the CRM. So how would you use these tools? All these tools, whether it is LinkedHub or it's LinkMatch, these are available as Chrome browser plugins. Now, I already have the plugin installed, so let me show you how it works. But before we go there, I wanted to just show you that these are the five contacts I have here. I'm going to sync a contact from here, which is non-existent. Let's take this one contact here. We're going to sync the information. And as you see, it suddenly shows up here and shows sync. You saw there were five contacts. What happens when I press sync here? And it says syncing and sync. Now, if I go here to my CRM and I just press refresh, a sixth contact has been added. So that's the unassigned contact. There is no owner assigned to it as yet. If I further open up my contact, you would see my communication with this contact has been added here. So that is the power of using something like LinkedHub. Now, LinkedHub is expensive, it is costly. There is an alternate to it, but that would not sync all your communication. That's called LinkMatch. Here we are on the website of LinkMatch. And if you go for the pricing for HubSpot, it's about $15 per user a month. Now this is pretty affordable because your CRM is free, and using this tool, you can actually sync all the information you want across. Prior to COVID-19 striking in, I was using this regularly and I was using it a lot to sync my contacts to my main account. Now I have just suspended the account for the time being, and I'm working more on my existing contacts rather than getting new clients in. This could be used the exact same way, and you could sync all the information across. This is my tool number two. So once I have my client here, what am I going to do? If you're familiar with my HubSpot CRM videos, you know I'm a great fan of using tags. And in this case, I'm going to put a tag here called LinkedIn. You could have any tag, that doesn't really matter. But before I save it here, let me show you what would happen when I put this tag here. So when I open up the lists, I do have a list called LinkedIn, which has five members. When I press save here and this contact is saved, this list becomes six. So since it's an active list, this contact has been added here. This contact now automatically using a zap has been pulled from my HubSpot CRM and has been sent to my email marketing solution. Finally, in the email marketing solution, what would happen is this particular contact would enter a funnel. Now, how this funnel would look like is, the minute the contact enters a funnel, the automation would take it to a Facebook audience, and it would keep him in the Facebook audience, target and retarget him depending upon how many visits this person has done to the website or how many downloads. And at the same time, on a parallel side, I would have built up 4 or a 5 or a 6 series sequence that I would be sending to this person to gradually warm them up. They would be getting from one side my emails, and from the other side they would be seeing me on the social media. And this way I would first set up a brand recall for them. Eventually from all those emails a communication would start, or maybe nothing would happen, in which case I would keep them in my audience for future retargeting. And if a communication starts, I know whether this is going to turn into a contact or this is going to stay a lead. If they stay a lead, I'll keep them in the Facebook or social media retargeting audiences. But now I will only retarget them once every 6 weeks or so, not on a regular basis. And I'll also only email them once every 4 to 6 weeks if I have any update to share with them. So that is how I would go about creating these audiences. And these are the four tools that I would use for that. So there you have it, guys. This is the process of how to warm up the prospects on LinkedIn and how to convert them to your customers or have them on your list so that if they don't buy today, you can sell to them some other time. I hope this video helped you. If it did, please do subscribe to my channel if not done so already. Your subscribing to my channel not only helps the channel grow, it also keeps me motivated to create more content like this. If you found the content relevant, do press the like button. Your like tells YouTube that the content is relevant and it gets pushed up. I thank you for your time. This is Ashal Mehra signing off, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.